Not long ago, I too had the opportunity to experience education at one of the state schools. In fact, I'm a graduate from Westchester University, and now I sit on their Council of Trustees, as the Chancellor knows. And Mr. Chancellor, I think I want to go back and talk about the enrollment trends. I think over the past year, there were maybe three universities that showed modest increase, Westchester, of course, being one, Cheyney, to our surprise, being the other, and I think it was maybe Slippery Rock.
Slippery Rock, East Stroudsburg.
Okay, that showed a slight increase. When I had the opportunity to talk to the administration at Westchester University, I pointedly asked, what is it that Westchester is doing to show continual growth? And part of what I thought I heard was marketing, you know, finding new students and just doing marketing even outside of the Philadelphia area. So it made me think. So then I met with the superintendent of Philadelphia School District, mm-hmm. talking about their outreach, you know, in regards to students graduating from Philadelphia schools and the relationship they had with universities. Now, it's my understanding that there is a relationship with universities, but it can be strengthened. My hope is that we can have further conversation to look at some of the local schools, primarily Cheyney University and maybe the Philadelphia school system, and try to
pipelines.
Bridge something. Right, exactly, with that. But in general, I guess my question is, what strategies are universities using? Like I said, I had a conversation with Westchester. They talk about marketing. I mean, is that the common theme or goal or strategy being utilized? Or are there problems related to courses offered that show a decline? Or is it just maybe because of tuition increases? Like, what do you see? And if you can be brief with that, because I have two other questions to ask you.
Marketing, as you might imagine, is an essential part of what we do. It's a word that sort of flies in the face of higher education, especially for a system that for a long time would open the doors and turn on the lights and be full. The bucking the trend that is now existing, which are declining enrollments, makes marketing even more important to new markets out of state, different parts of the state than traditionally that university went to. But suffice it to say, they have to be very strategic marketing decisions because there is only so much money you can put into it. And Dr. Soltz gave a great answer to this very question, representative at the last meeting. I wondered if he might want to piggyback onto that.
Briefly.
Well, I think we market very broadly, and we also look for different audiences. Bloomsburg and many of the other universities are looking more for transfer students as well, non-traditional students in terms of older students, students who've dropped out. So a lot of that is spreading a broader net. We used to, many of us, focus totally on high school graduates, first-time freshmen.
Great.
And now we've broadened.
Community college transfers is a big focus for the future.
All right, I think I have 2 minutes left, so I want to try to throw in these two questions real quick. Since 1982, according to information I received, Cheyney has had more presidents, including interim presidents, than any other school in the system. I know that the Middle States had made a recommendation that Cheyney needs permanent leadership. Last year, I asked a question at the same hearings in regards to the plan to hire a permanent president for Cheyney University. I thought the answer was that over the next year that would take place. Can you give me an update where we are with that?
Yes, sir, and that was the original plan, but because of continued difficulties and the possibility that putting a national all-call out there might be difficult based on the circumstances that were added to that list, including probationary status as far as accreditation is concerned, mounting debt to the system, and, of course, the $30 million possible debt to the feds, we decided to postpone. As of yesterday, with the decision that was made by the board to work with Cheyney to do a significant pivot to a more sustainable future, a leadership look is going to be very important to that, finding the right person who can come in and lead the charge on that change in direction is going to be essential to us. But I think also the board sent a very important message out there that there intends to be a Cheyney and make that search a little bit more palatable to interested qualified parties.
Great. So you sort of answered my last question. I think I have 15 seconds left. So the last question was, are there plans to close Cheyney University? And I thought I heard you just say,
no. Yesterday, what the board did was to provide one more round of transitional funding, and with the statement that we were that the plan that is currently on the table is going to require years of additional funding that the system just doesn't have anymore, and therefore in the time remaining for that transitional period, we're going to have to pivot for a new model for Cheyney that will very quickly see revenue match expenditure, and thus creating a future for the institution that is sustainable.
Great. Okay, I know my time's up. So that means, Cheyney, there's no plan to close Cheyney University?
There is not.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.